News breaking overnight on the Ebola outbreak. The World Health Organization is now calling it an international health emergency. And this morning, the husband of Nancy Reitbol is speaking out about her battle with the deadly virus. ABC's Steve Osunsami is tracking it all from Atlanta, where she is being treated. Steve, good morning.
Good morning, Amy. Her husband remains in Liberia, where he continues their missionary work. He says that he and his wife were choosing to put themselves at great risk because of the incredible need.
Overnight, the World Health Organization declaring the spread of Ebola in West Africa an international health emergency. And this morning, the husband of one of the sick missionaries in isolation here at this Atlanta hospital is speaking out for the first time.
We spent 40 years together, plus we're junior high sweethearts.
David Reitbol calling home from the deadly Ebola hot zone in Liberia, thanking God and the doctors for bringing his wife Nancy back from the brink of death.
I'm grateful and happy that she's in a place that enables her to receive the best care possible, and that will give her every opportunity to get better and to recover.
Here she is, helping disinfect doctors in the Ebola ward of her African missionary hospital before getting sick, needing this emergency flight to Atlanta Tuesday for treatment.
I really want to give thanks to God for providing those people, but also more than that, to also thank them for their contribution.
In an exclusive interview, ABC News reached the six Tuskegee University students on a study abroad trip, now stranded in Liberia after flights from the region were suspended.
I was freaking out.
They're working with British Airways to fly home through Ghana before school starts August 20th.
I personally would like everyone to know that we are safe. We are safe and we are healthy. The only thing we're concerned about is getting home as soon as possible.
Here in the U.S., the CDC telling Congress that they're sending more teams to Africa to stop the disease at its source.